Behold, my friends, for the journey is finally at an end. It's taken me over a year and a half to both acquire and review all 8 Studio Series Constructicons. Originally, I wasn't expecting to receive Overload in the mail until October, though considering how long it took me to get around to making this video, what difference did it make? But luckily for me, Amazon sent him to my doorstep a month early. I even ordered him for Voyager price to boot. Was it worth it? Well, welcome to Kit Catastrophe. My name is Kit, and today we'll be taking a look at Transformers Studio Series Leader Class Constructicon Overload. This figure was released in 2020 as part of Wave 5 of the Leader Assortment, and represents Overload's appearance in the 2009 film Transformers Revenge of the Fallen. According to the Transformers Wiki, Overload's alternate mode is an articulated dump truck, but I'm not buying it. Sure, at first glance it has the same general shape and proportions that you'd expect from such a vehicle, but once you look a little bit closer for more than a femtosecond, things get a little ropey. I suppose the first thing one would notice about this train wreck is the massive ratchet joint in plain view on either side of what is supposed to be a dump bucket. This alone shatters the illusion that this is supposed to be a functional vehicle, since the bucket just kinda materializes out of thin air on its frontier, making the profile of this truck more jarring than a mismatched MicroMaster combiner. The rest of the bucket tries to salvage what little respect and dignity it can muster, but that fails too, as the bucket is completely filled in from above and even has an uneven tail. The designers seem to try to make it look like something, as there are tons of sculpted ridges going across the top, but there's no way this is anything but some connecting slots for Devastator's legs. I'll give the sculptors some credit, as there are some nice silver grates and grids on the side of the bucket that resemble those found on Longhaul, but even that's kinda ruined for me since it reminds me of a far more superior dump truck Decepticon. The front half of the truck is probably where Overload looks the best, though that's not really saying much. Everything here is pretty utilitarian, but still convincing. The cab is nice and squared off, with dark bluish-gray windows and a slick black roof. Next to it are some silver valves and pipes and various other componentry. The steep face of the truck is angular and immense, with a nicely ridged grille, though I wish it were given a silver paint wash. The wheels are huge and beefy and help give this vehicle a nice sense of scale. See, this is the culmination of that phenomenon I mentioned in my Studio Series Scavenger review, where I said that the Constructicon's alternate modes are getting progressively more and more compromised to make the combined mode work. I think Overload is the ultimate example of this, as his vehicle mode is a pathetic, cobbled-together excuse for a dump truck. Under any other circumstances, this would probably be enough to warrant a catastrophic rating, but I've messed around with Devastator in his combined mode, so I can't be too harsh on Overload. There's a lot of weight on his shoulders, both metaphorically and literally, and he's basically the keystone to the whole project, so of course the vehicle mode sucks donkey dick. Overload actually comes with an accessory, that being a sheath that is supposed to slip over Mixmaster's drum in combined mode to make Devastator's neck look more screen accurate. It has neon green paint so blinding that I haven't seen a shade like this since Deluxe Class Ratchet 2 years ago. I'll mention it in its proper context in my Devastator review, but for now all I need to mention is that it can clip onto Overload's bucket like so. Out of all of the Constructicons, sans the Deluxes and perhaps Mixmaster, Overload's transformation into robot mode is probably the simplest. Really, it's just a case of standing the dump truck and unfurling everything that was furled to begin with. The front wheels are a bit annoying to deal with, as there's hardly anywhere for them to lock or at least soft lock into place on the thigh, compounded by the fact that they're on the same joint as the robot mode knee. The robot arms are kind of daunting to deal with, as there are about 25 duodecillion different joints between the four of them, so there's a lot of variation to be had in how you choose to display Overload in robot mode. There are these gray tabs inside the outer shoulders that lock them in place that are mainly for combined mode, but feel free to use them for robot mode if you prefer the extra stability. The cab from vehicle mode pegs into the upper back and forms a rather pathetic little stinger, which is a far cry from the huge grabby arm seen on the original Revenge of the Fallen Legends class figure. Now, I wouldn't exactly call the transformation good by any stretch of the imagination, but at least it's easy. You know, I'm starting to feel as if the default settings for Decepticons in the movieverse are ultra-wide behemoth, because this is the third Studio Series Decepticon I've covered with those exact same parameters. I swear, it's as if Overload can T-pose without even stretching his arms. He's kind of a shelf hog because of it, though I expect that won't be an issue for most people. I really love the four-armed nature of this robot mode. For a Constructicon, it's very unique, though maybe not quite as unique as the wholly inhuman Hightower. Like I mentioned during the transformation sequence, there really is no wrong answer for how these massive hulking shoulders and arms should be displayed, as there are enough joints in here and enough variation in those joints for pretty much everything to look just about right. I really love how in lieu of traditional hands, Overload opts for massive meat hooks and pincer claws. Put him in the right pose and he looks like a massive crab or shrimp if it were bipedal. Speaking of which, the legs are absolutely pathetic. No, it's not because they're small or anything, I feel that they look good and fit his proportions nigh perfectly. It's just that the actual supportive struts are so very thin, and the knee joints are extremely weak. Given how top-heavy Overload's design is, it doesn't take much to topple him over. What makes things even worse are how the heel spurs stick out too far downward, sacrificing what could have been a more stable standing base. Of course, I have heard reports of copies that don't have this problem, so your mileage may vary. Things aren't all bad, however, as there is a lot more silver paint revealed in this mode. In fact, pretty much all of the paint used on this figure is revealed in robot mode. There's gallons of it picking out various mechanical details on his shoulders and his arms, as well as some more applied onto sculpted ladders on Overload's torso. That brings us to the head sculpt. Out of all of the Studio Series Constructicons, I feel Overload's is the least distinct, probably because his robot mode was never featured in the film. Then again, neither were Scrap Metals or Hightowers, at least in any serious detail, so what's his excuse? Finally, Overload features a stinger of sorts on the top of his hunched back. Yeah, it looks pretty pathetic.
All my gripes about stability aside, Overload is actually a pretty articulated figure. Starting at the head, he has a very tight ball joint. It's actually really hard to turn it all the way around, but you can do it, and it helps if you disengage the sternum piece from the rest of the torso, but it can look left and right. It can also look up very far, because it has a very nice cut to allow for that. The little stubby stinger can pivot back and forth to and fro as so. The shoulders are on massive, massive ratchet joints, but they're pretty quiet, and there's lots of detents, and they can go all the way around very nicely. There is a major joint up here that allows for some outward motion and downward motion. This is the prescribed method of displaying his shoulders, but you can get the arms a little lower than that. And as you just saw me demonstrate, there is another shoulder joint here, which allows for even more outward motion. There is actually one final joint that I forgot to mention in my initial recording, and that is a ratchet joint which is used for both sets of arms, which is an extremely tight joint, and it allows for better forward motion than the other joints featured within these arms allow. The main arms have a massive swivel that would in theory allow for 360 degrees of rotation, but in practice, things do collide around here, but you can manage past it. There are two elbow joints here, one that goes this far and the other that goes even farther than that, and these two claws here are on a conjoined hinge that allows them to move forward and backwards. The other arm has a hinge here, and a double hinge here that allows for some nice curl. And there is a swivel right here that allows the pincer to move. The actual claws don't open or close, which some people might be a little disappointed in, but I don't really care as much. The hips move forward, but they don't move very far backwards because of the backpack. They can move outwards a fair deal, though these hip wheels do get in the way of a lot of motion in these hip joints, meaning that you kind of have to get them out of the way to get a high kick. They also impede the thigh swivel just a little bit, not so much inwards, but a little bit on the outward splay. The knees bend a piss poor degree. This is hardly a knee bend. They can bend a little forward. This kneecap piece can move forward, I suppose. The ankles can pivot a fair degree, mostly due to transformation, and the heel can move inwards, I suppose. I don't really see how helpful that will be. I don't really see how helpful many of these joints will be, considering at least my copy of Overload has some extreme balance issues, or stability issues, that I have gone into detail about earlier. But if your copy has a stronger constitution than mine, and that's not hard, you could potentially get some nice poses out of him.
As always, we move into Overload's combined mode by starting from that abhorrent excuse of an alternate mode. Basically, the main departures from the path to robot mode involve unfurling one pair of robot arms and reshaping the robot shoulders so that they lock in some entirely new places, beefing out Devastator's thighs. From there, the lower body of Overload just kind of splays open and awaits Demolisher to mount him. Overload's combined form is the least recognizable out of all of the Constructicons, since it's not entirely apparent what exactly he turns into. For all I know, he could just be trying to cosplay as Revenge of the Fallen Soundwave satellite mode. I'll cover this in more depth when I take a look at Devastator in his entirety, but what will become the combiner hips and legs are full of some extremely heavy ratcheting joints, which I think was the right call. It may make Overload a bit more of a pain to pose in robot mode, but I can say that it's all worth it. Studio Series Overload is the runt of his litter, and an absolute failure of a standalone figure. The vehicle mode is a blocky, gappy, incoherent mess, and the robot mode is an unstable disgrace. Of course, that's not saying he's all bad. I do absolutely love his general aesthetic in robot mode, as I have said many times when it comes to Revenge of the Fallen characters, and more importantly, I recognize that most of Overload's problems stem from the fact that the success of the combined mode is placed entirely onto him, so naturally his other modes have to be majorly compromised. While in due time, we'll see that it was worth it in the end, Overload just simply isn't very good on his own. It's kind of a relief that I only spent 30 bucks on him back when he was on pre-order on Amazon, otherwise I'd have felt ripped off. As much as it pains me to do this, Overload is the absolute worst of the Studio Series Constructicons, and as such, he gets the rank of tragic. That being said, if you're already this deep into forming Devastator, he's still worth the pickup. If you like this video or otherwise found it helpful or informative, then please subscribe for more reviews like this in the future, and feel free to suggest topics for future reviews in the comments. When we return, I'll be taking one last detour before the big event. We can't just settle on an odd number, can we? This has been Kit Katastrophe. Transform and roll out.